Who speaks for New Jersey? I'll tell you. One guy, at least. His name is Mike Testa, and he is a brand new state senator fighting for you. What's going on, Senator? How are you?
What's going on, Bill? Great to hear your voice. Great to be on your show again. I hope all is well, and you're preparing for the Christmas season here.
Well, I'd said this, Mike. I'm like, can the politicians just give me a break for a couple days? I'd really like to talk about food and what we're doing for the holidays. And I just, you know, these guys, they can't get out of their own way. I want to congratulate you, though. You stood up. I heard so much feedback about your performance at the State House during this debate over vaccines and the role of government and all this stuff, losing the religious exemption. You were a very strong voice, and the folks that were there, and I've made this very clear, this was not an anti-vax, pro-vax. This was about parents being able to make informed choices without the government coming in and telling them how to raise their own kids.
I couldn't agree with you more. It comes down to informed consent issues. You know, there's parents that are very concerned about the scheduling of the vaccinations. I mean, if we're going to really get into the science behind it, why would we bundle vaccinations the way many of the schedules are already performed? God forbid something does go wrong with a child with a bad reaction to a vaccination.
Right.
How are you going to isolate it to the one vaccination if you're giving 3, 4 or possibly 5 at a time the way they bundle them currently? This, you're absolutely right. This is not a pro-vax versus anti-vax issue.
Right.
Bill, one of the things that I said that really rung home with a lot of people was, think about this, in the state of New Jersey, if you're a criminal suspect who is accused or suspected of killing another individual while operating your motor vehicle, potentially under the influence of alcohol or an intoxicating drug, narcotic drug, the state needs to get a warrant to pierce your skin, to withdraw blood from you, to determine whether, in fact, you were under the influence at the time of committing the crime.
Right.
However, there's not going to be any necessary court order or warrant to pierce a little child's skin.
What a great point. What a great point, Mike.
Against the consent of their own parents.
It's incredible that Steve Sweeney is still pushing this. And I want to thank you because you are a voice of fresh opposition that finally got to Trenton and said, no more. We're going to take on the special interests. We're going to take on Steve Sweeney and all these backroom deals. And, you know, this fake fight between Sweeney and Murphy, the truth is the result on the other side of that fight is higher taxes for all of us. So you've got illegal aliens now with getting driver's licenses. You've got the cap on taxes being erased if the governor signs it. And I don't know if he's going to sign it or not. And I tell people, this is because Steve Sweeney wants to go around you. The voters have voted down almost $1 billion in new spending and taxes over the past 14 months. And Sweeney's like, that's not good. We need Trenton to act. So let me ask you this. Back to the vaccination issue. This is going to come up again. Sweeney thinks he's going to have the votes. What are you doing to prepare for what could be a January 6th or January 13th battle?
Look, so many parents showed up. It was a wonderful outpouring of true Americanism, in my opinion. Those mothers and fathers, and many of them brought their children with them, came in a voice of solidarity to show all of the politicians in Trenton, say, we're here and we're opposed to this.
Yeah.
And I don't think that they're going away. I think that
the
sleeping giant has been awoken, and that is New Jersey concerned mothers.
Yeah.
I think that's the last group any elected official wants to upset.
That's right.
Is a large group of mama bears, as they were calling themselves. That's not me calling them that, of mama bears who were very concerned about what goes into their children's bodies.
And, you know, a lot of those moms, Mike, they called all day. I mean, really all week. For 2 days, we were flooded with young moms. This is the constituency, as you've said correctly, that no politician can afford to upset. When you rile them up, they were, you know, late 20s, early 30s. These are voting moms who are making the big decision as to whether or not their families are going to stay in New Jersey. And they were ready to fight, and fight they did. And I just want to thank you for being that voice of common sense, reasonable families in New Jersey. You did an outstanding job. Thank God you won that election and you were in Trenton. So anything I can do to help you going forward, you let me know. How do people get in touch with you, Mike?
Well, the easiest way is to go to our Facebook page.
Okay.
At Senator Michael Testa. My political page is still Mike Testa from the campaign side of things. That's the easiest way right now because my district office isn't even set up yet, as you can imagine. I just got sworn in. It's hilarious, isn't it?
I've only been a senator now for a week and a half.
And you have already pissed off
every establishment leader and corrupt insider there is. I love it. Keep fighting, Mike. We're with you.
Absolutely. If I could just make one, one showing. You know, in the morning when I was on the Transportation Committee as a substitute, that committee decided to establish a privilege in driver's licenses that has not been recognized by our Constitution, by any of our laws, or any of our jurisprudence. They established a privilege to a group of individuals who absolutely do not have, well, now they do because we voted on it, and I'm assuming the governor's going to sign it, but that never have had the privilege to have driver's licenses. And in the afternoon, when I was in the Health Committee, that committee determined to take away one of the most well-established constitutional protected rights in the right to practice one's religion freely.
That's right. So that you've articulated exactly what's going on in New Jersey. They are the Democrats and the majority have become the party of criminals and illegals at your expense, at the expense of the Constitution, at the expense of average working and middle class families. Thank God they've got at least one voice. You're going to hear from some more this morning. Get in touch with Senator Mike Testa. Mike, we're going to have you back on very soon. Thank you for joining me.